Freddie Mercury's former manager, Paul Prenter, was played by actor Alan Leach in the Bohemian Rhapsody movie, but just how accurate was that portrayal, and who is the actual Paul Prenter? Obviously, the film changed some aspects of Queen's past to fit a suitable on-screen story, but a lot of what happens is the truth. Prenter was in fact Freddie's manager from 1977 to 1986. They were also lovers at one point in time, however their relationship took a turn for the worse after the release of Queen's album Hot Space in 1982, where the other members made it clear their dislike for him. May and Taylor were not happy with the album and blamed Paul for the influence he had over the sound, and sure enough the album wasn't well received, with Q magazine listing it as one of the albums in which rock musicians lost their touch. The terms Judas and Devil's Spawn have been associated with Prenter, often coming from devoted Queen fans. Most of the hatred stems from Prenter selling his story to a national newspaper after Freddie and he broke up. He went into deep detail about Mercury's lifestyle and claims that he slept with hundreds of men. Freddie was so scared he would catch it. It was more likely that I would see him walk on water than go with a woman, Prenter said. Once his friends started dying, Freddie knew his wild life had to stop. Freddie told me his first homosexual relationship happened when he was at boarding school in India when he was 14, he said. While we were touring, there would be a different man every night. He would probably go to bed by 6 a.m. or 7 a.m, but rarely alone. He has a fear of sleeping alone or even being alone for long stretches. Paul also claimed that two of his former lovers had died of AIDS, convinced it was because of this that Freddie turned his back on his hectic lifestyle. Jim Hutton, Freddie's eventual partner, said, "We later learned that Prenter had been paid about £32,000 by the paper for his story." Hutton wrote, "Freddie never spoke to him again. For the next few days there were more in the sun at each episode of Prenter's story, Freddie became angrier. Prenter sold the paper several photographs of Freddie with various lovers, and these were thrown over two pages under the heading, All the Queen's Men." Hutton added that Prenter had tried to get in touch with Mercury to explain, ringing Garden Lodge, but Freddie wouldn't speak to him. After Paul sold photos of Freddie, he went back to Belfast and ended up spending all the cash he received from the deal. Freddie himself didn't publicly acknowledge he had the sexually transmitted disease until he released a statement on November 23, 1991, the day before his death. Following the enormous conjecture in the press over the last 2 weeks, I wish to confirm that I have been tested HIV positive and have AIDS. I felt it correct to keep this information private to date in order to protect the privacy of those around me. However, the time has now come for my friends and fans around the world to know the truth, and I hope that everyone will join with me, my doctors and all those worldwide, in the fight against this terrible disease. Prenter died from AIDS-related complications in August 1991, just 3 months before Mercury died. So that is what happened with Paul Prenter. The information about his life was more difficult to work out than I initially thought it would be, as Queen seemed to not want anything to do with him after he was fired. Anyway guys, thank you so much for watching. See you next time.